So in this video, I'm going to be going over 10 hidden features inside Premiere Pro that you might not be aware of. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
So the first tip comes with music. Say if I have this music clip and I want to align it to the cut point, you can see I can't because when I go left and right one frame at a time, the beat's just slightly off. Now to change this and to adjust it more accurately, we can turn on the time units in our timeline panel. So to do that, just go to the hamburger menu and change to show audio time units. Once this is selected, you'll notice that your time code changes to audio samples and you can zoom in a lot further now, and now you can click and drag and align it to the beat. One other thing that you might want to display as a video editor is see-through edits. A good example when to turn this on is, say if I'm working in this timeline and I don't know which cuts are jump cuts or match cuts. Show through edits will show the through edits of a certain clip. So for example, if we turn it on by going to the wrench and going to show through edits, you can see that this little arrow icon appears in the cut points where it's a through edit. So if we zoom in and play it back, you'll notice that it's a through edit, it's not a jump cut. So I have this clip in the timeline. What if I want to copy it and maybe put it on video track 2? A good keyboard shortcut to do that is hold down Option and click and drag up and slide it over. This easily creates a duplicate of that clip. But what if you wanted to copy it there and paste it using your keyboard? Well, by default, if you're using the Premiere Pro default, if you hit Command C and say you go out here and hit Command V, you'll notice that it pastes it into the same track that it was copied from, not in the targeted track in video track 2. You can change this in your keyboard shortcuts. So say if we go up to Premiere Pro keyboard shortcuts, what you'll want to do is search for paste and then scroll down. Under the panel section and timeline panel, you'll want to delete paste to same track, this little X here, and then click next to paste to target track. Click on that and hit Command V, and this will change that. Once you click OK, and now when we hit Command V, you'll notice that it pastes it to video track 2 rather than the track that it was copied originally from. Now, one other thing you might do often as a video editor is move clips around. Say if I want this clip to be, you know, at this cut point. Now you could just, like, you know, move this clip over, move this clip over, select these, move this over, and then click and drag this down over here, but that takes a lot of steps. An easier way is to click on the clip that you want to move, hold down Command and click and drag to the right, release, and you can see that those two clips have flip-flopped. Same thing, if you click, hold down Command and click and drag to the right, you can see that we're shifting this clip down the timeline. Now we have a lot of B-roll clips in our timeline, but it would be nice to see thumbnails of what these clips look like. You can turn on video thumbnails by clicking on the wrench button and going to show video thumbnails. Now we can have a better idea of what clips are being displayed in our timeline here. So a lot of times I work with adjustment layers to add different coloring effects. You can see I added this one to add a Lumetri color effect to my face so that I stand out from the background. But one thing you'll notice is that the mask is drawn a little short and I want to expand the edges. Now instead of clicking and dragging each point to get it closer to the edge, what you can actually do is use this hidden feature. If you hover around the vertex point, you'll notice that the rotation icon appears over the vertex point. Now once that appears, hold down Shift and then click and drag. You'll notice that the whole mask expands now. So this is an easy way to make a mask shorter or larger by doing that. Now you'll also notice in this clip here, I'm missing my audio from my video clip. And to get it back, what you can do is click on the clip and click F on your keyboard, and this will open it in the source monitor. You can click on the audio and then click and drag it back to your timeline to realign and re-add in the audio to your timeline. One tool I use often for color grading is Comparison View. By default, the program monitor just displays one image, but you can change this by going into the wrench icon and going to Comparison View. Now you can see two clips side by side. You even have controls down below with the different ways that you can display them, and this is really nice for color matching. And also, just to show you, if we go back to the original, to change the reference clip, you can just click and drag to the left or right to change what the reference clip is that you want to reference. And this is an easy way to show two clips at the same time. Now, one other color correcting tool that I do while doing this is the apply match. Say if I want to apply the color grade from this clip to this clip, what we can go and do is go into our color options, our color mode, and then navigate to color wheels and match, and then click apply match. And you'll notice that both clips are now matched with the same type of color grade look. Now, one other thing you might want to do as a video editor is replace clips in your timeline with clips from either the source monitor or possibly even the project panel. You can easily do that by right-clicking on the clip in the timeline and going to replace with clip from source monitor or from bin. For example, if we go to source monitor, you can see it replaces it, or even if we right-click and go from bin, it replaces it from there as well. Now, when doing this, if the clips are longer or shorter, you'll notice that sometimes it doesn't have enough information, so you'll just have to trim the edge if it's shorter, or if it's longer, it won't display all of it. One other common thing that happens when you're video editing is you'll create a graphic or some type of text file animation like this on the screen. But sometimes other things happen in your sequence where, you know, you need to expand this animation. You need to, like, you know, click and drag this out, and then you would have to go into effects controls, and then you would have to click and try to, you know, realign these keyframes, expand the animation. But what you can do instead is set up protected regions to these keyframes inside effects controls. So if you notice at the very top of effects controls here and near the timeline, you can click and drag these little blue icons out, these little handles, and you can even click once to apply it to the keyframes. And you'll notice now when we expand the clip or the edge of the clip now, you can see that the keyframes are adjusted to the new length of time. So those are some hidden features inside Premiere Pro that I use as a video editor. Which one did you like? Leave a comment down below. I'd love to hear from you. That does it for this video. We'll see you guys in the next one.